In this video, we are talking about horizontal circular motion and vertical circular motion. So first of all, I am talking about the horizontal circular motion. What is horizontal circular motion? When an object is moving in a circular path, then it is known as horizontal circular motion. And the object is on the surface of Earth. It is means the gravity is not affecting the motion of the object. So I am taking it as horizontal circular motion. Now let this one is the reference point, and suppose it one is marked as P, and this point is initial point capital A, where is the object, and it is moving on this circular path, and the radius of this circular path is small r. Suppose the object starts from point A and reaches at point B after covering this arc, which is equal to, let it be delta S, and finally it reaches at point B. Now, if this center is taken as O, then at point B, this complete whole angle BOP, I am taking it as theta 2, and angle this one only, AOP, I am taking it as theta 1. Then, what will be angle BOA? Angle BOA will be equal to theta 2 minus theta 1, and this one is known as angular displacement of the particle. So theta 2 minus theta 1 is the angular displacement of the particle, or I can also name it as delta theta. It means change in angle. Delta represents change, so it can be written as change in angle. We also know that angle is equals to arc upon radius. So angle, what is the angle forming here is delta theta, and what is the arc, that is delta S, and what is the radius, that is a small r. So I can write it as delta theta is equals to delta S upon r. So here delta theta is representing angular displacement of the particle, and it is measured, its SI unit is radian. It is measured in radian. Its SI unit is radian. It is a dimensionless quantity. There are no dimensions. So it is M0, L0, T0. It's the dimension formula for it. And sometime it is also measured in degree. What is the relation between degree and radian? 180 degree is equals to pi radian. For radian, we use the symbol half circle, or I can say C, and for degree we use generally 0, or I can say O. So 180 degree is equals to pi radian. So this one is the angular displacement of the particle. Now for angular velocity, see what was the displacement on the linear motion. It was the distance between the final and the initial point. Similarly, what is the angular displacement? It is the angle between the final and the initial point. What was the linear velocity earlier? It was the differentiation of the displacement. Similarly, angular velocity omega, it will be equal to delta theta upon delta t. Means if delta theta angle is changed in the time of delta t, or I can say rate of change of theta, with rate of change of theta is known as angular velocity. This one is omega, not the w, it is curved, and we can also write it as d theta upon dt. Means differentiation of theta with respect to time is known as angular velocity. What will be its SI unit? Its SI unit will be radian per second. Its SI unit will be radian per second. This one will be SI unit for angular velocity. Fine. In some books, omega is also written as limit delta t tends to 0, delta theta upon delta t. So what is this? This one is limit delta t tends to 0, which means that when this time is very less, then this one is known as omega, or I can say angular velocity. Fine. One more thing, when the theta is, or I can say delta theta is 180 degree, और 2 pi means for the whole path, sorry, it is 360 degree, or 2 pi means when the object is starting from let the point P and it makes the angle of 360 degree and comes back to point P, then delta theta will be 360 degree or 2 pi. Then the time taken in this process is known as capital T, or I can say it is time period. Time period. Fine. And what is frequency? Frequency, it is represented by nu. Nu, NEU. It is the pronunciation of the symbol, and it is given by 1 upon capital T, that is the reciprocal of time period. The frequency, its unit is hertz, time period is in seconds, or it may be in minutes also, but for the SI, I am taking it as second. And frequency, it can be second inverse or hertz. So this is the frequency. Now, if I want to find the relation between the omega and frequency, then what I can write, see, what was the angular velocity? Angular velocity was omega is equals to delta theta upon delta t. So delta theta, if delta theta is equal to 2 pi, then what will be time? It will be equal to capital T. So from here I can write it as 2 pi nu. So omega will be equal to 2 pi nu. Now we will derive the relation between the linear velocity and the angular velocity. Let the object is moving in the circular path with the initial point A, and after covering some distance, it reaches the point B, such that the arc covered in this process, the arc covered is delta S and the angle made is delta D. So, if I want to write the relation between delta D and delta S, then I can write it as delta D arc is angle is equals to arc upon radius, or it will be delta S upon R. Fine. I am dividing both sides with respect to delta T, so it will be delta theta upon delta T is equals to 1 by R times of delta S upon delta T. Now, taking limits on the both sides, I can write it as limit delta T tends to 0, delta theta upon delta T is equals to 1 by R limit delta T tends to 0, delta S upon delta T. See, when it is given in this format that limit delta T tends to 0, I can say limit the denominator is approaching 0, and here delta first quantity is given with respect to delta second quantity, then we can change it in the differentiation form. So it will become d theta upon dt, which will be equal to 1 by r ds upon dt. Now, d theta upon dt, we know that this is the differentiation of angular displacement with respect to time, and it will become omega is equals to, this is velocity, so it will be v by r. So I can write it as v is equals to r omega, and this is the relation between velocity, angular velocity and linear velocity, where v is the linear velocity of the particle and r is the radius and omega is the angular velocity of the particle. Fine. If I want to write it in vector form, then I will write it as v vector. It will be equal to cross product of omega and r, omega vector and r vector. So this is the another formula or the another relation which is in the vector form in v and omega. Now we will also talk about here angular acceleration. What is angular acceleration? Angular acceleration, as we have talked about angular velocity and angular displacement, similarly the angular acceleration will be differentiation of angular velocity. I can say alpha will be equal to d omega upon dt, or it is the differentiation of omega with respect to time. Fine. And if again I want to find the relation
between linear acceleration and angular acceleration, then what I can write, I can differentiate this on the both sides, so it will become dv by dt is equals to r d omega by dt plus omega dr by dt. Fine. So dv by dt will be acceleration, linear acceleration, and r, and d omega by dt. D omega by dt is alpha, so it will be alpha plus. What is dr by dt? R is radius and radius is constant in the circular motion, so this part will be zero. Hence, it will be equal to a is equals to r alpha. So this is the relation between linear acceleration and angular acceleration, where a is the linear acceleration and alpha is the angular acceleration. And for writing its vector form, I can write it as a vector will be equal to alpha vector cross product of with r vector. So this is the vector form of the relation linear acceleration and angular acceleration, where a is the linear acceleration and alpha is the angular acceleration. Similarly, if we talk about the centripetal acceleration, then what is centripetal acceleration in the circular motion? When the object is moving on the circular path, then what happens? A force acts towards the center, which enables us to move in the circular path. A force always acts towards the center, and that force is known as centripetal force. If I draw it like this and the particle is here, then centripetal force will be acting in this direction. If particle is here, then the centripetal force will be acting in this direction. If the particle is here, then the centripetal force will be acting in this direction. Means a force is acting towards the center every time when the particle is moving in the circular path. That force is known as centripetal force, and acceleration generated due to that force is known as centripetal acceleration. And the formula for the centripetal acceleration is v square upon r, or putting the value of v as r omega, I can write it as r square omega square upon r, or it will be equal to omega square r. So there are two formulas for the centripetal acceleration. First one is v square by r, and the second one is a is equals to omega square r. Now this is for the when the object is moving with the uniformly accelerated motion, means the object is moving with the constant speed in the circular path. If the speed is changing continuously, then there will be two forces. When the speed is changing continuously, I can write it as it is variable speed in circular motion. When the object is moving with the variable speed in circular motion, then what we can say, then there will be two accelerations. First acceleration, if the object is here, then there will be two accelerations. First acceleration will be in this direction, and that is known as tangential acceleration, and the second acceleration will be acting in this direction, and the particle is going like this. Then there are two accelerations here. First one is tangential acceleration and the second one is centripetal acceleration. So these are the two vector quantities, so there must be a resultant in this direction. This will be the resultant A, and I can write it as tangential acceleration. This one is tangential acceleration and this one is centripetal acceleration. So I can write it as tangential acceleration will be equal to r alpha, and we have already derived it. Simply, centripetal acceleration will be equal to v square by r. We have also studied it here, and the net acceleration a will be equal to square root of addition of both. So this will be the net acceleration when the object is moving with the variable speed. And if the object is moving with the constant speed, then only the centripetal acceleration will be acting. Now we will discuss about the motion in the vertical circle. Suppose this is an object and it is moving in the circular path, and this circular path is in the vertical direction. Means the object is moving like this. Or I can say this is the earth surface, and object is going above the earth surface and comes back to earth surface again. So let this is the particle P on which we have tied a string at the point O, and this particle is moving in the vertical circular path, and let this is the horizontal vertical line, and I am marking its point as capital H, means the highest point, and similarly capital L as the lowest point. Capital L as the lowest point. And I am also drawing a perpendicular line. This point is N, such that the distance OL is equal to the radius, that is a small r, and NL is equals to the height from the surface of earth. So I can write it as ON will be equal to R minus H. Similarly, a tension is acting towards the center, that is T, and object is moving in anti-clockwise direction, and gravity will be acting downwards, so there will be gravity in this direction mg, and by making its component, if I take this as theta, then the two components of the gravity will be like this. First one will be here, and it will be equal to mg cos theta, and the second one will be here, this one will be equal to mg sin theta. So this component will be mg cos theta, and this component will be mg sin theta. And at the lowest point, let the particle has moved in this direction with the initial velocity u, and at this point let the particle's velocity becomes v. Fine. Now we have to find tension and velocity at the lowest point, highest point, and at a general point. Fine. Okay. So first of all, I am finding the velocity at any point. Velocity at any general point. To find the velocity at any general point means I have to find the velocity at P. I am applying the law of conservation of energy, that total energy at L will be equal to total energy at P. So total energy at L will be equal to total energy at P. Now, what will be the total energy at L? It will be kinetic energy. Kinetic energy will be half mv square plus half mu square, because the velocity is u here, plus this is the kinetic energy, and the potential energy will be zero, because I am assuming that this is the surface of the earth and object is just about to touch the surface. It has not touched the surface, but the height from the surface of the earth is zero at the point L. And total energy at P will be equal to kinetic energy half mv square plus the potential energy, that will be equal to mgh, and NL. NL distance is h, so I can write it as mgh. Now, from here, I can find it as v square will be equal to u square minus 2gh, or I can write it as v will be equal to square root of u square minus 2gh. So this is the velocity at any general point when the particle is moving in vertical circular motion. Now we want to find the tension at this point. So tension at any general point, or I can say tension at point P, I want to find. So what I will write it as, at this point, what will be the tension? See, tension is acting in the inwards direction, and mg cos theta is acting in the outward direction. Also, their difference will be the net force acting in the inward direction, and that will be equal to the centripetal force. So I can write it as T minus mg cos theta. T minus mg cos theta, it will be equal to mv square upon r. Mv square upon r. Now, I can put the value of cos theta from this triangle. It will be equal to base upon hypotenuse, and I can also put the velocity of v from here. So टी माइनस एम जी, वॉट विल बी कॉस थीटा? कॉस थीटा विल बी आर माइनस एच अपॉन आर, इट इज बाय द बेस अपॉन हाइपोटेनियस, एंड एम बाय आर, वॉट इज वी स्क्वायर? वी स्क्वायर इज यू स्क्वायर माइनस टू जी एच. ऑन सॉल्विंग दिस आई विल गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ टी एज एम बाय आर विल बी कॉमन, एंड इन द ब्रैकेट आई विल गेट यू स्क्वायर माइनस 3gh plus gr, so I am writing it as u square plus gr minus 3gh. So this will be the tension at any general point in the vertical circular motion. I have solved this directly. I have skipped one step here. Now if I want to find tension at lowest point and the highest point, tension at lowest point. Tension at lowest point and the highest point I want to find. So tension at lowest point will be equal to, what will be the height at the lowest point? It will be 0. So this part will be 0. So TL, tension at lowest point, will be equal to M by R U square plus GR. This is the tension at the lowest point. Similarly, tension at the highest point will be equal to tension at highest point. Tension at highest point, and tension at highest point will be equal to TH, and it will be equal to M by R. What will be the height at the highest point? H will be equal to twice of radius. So putting here twice of radius, we will get it as M by R U square minus 5GR. So this one will be the tension at the highest point. Now if we want to find the minimum velocity at the lowest point, so what we can say, for the object to move in the complete circular path and we want to find the minimum velocity at the lowest point, so tension at the highest point will be equal to greater than zero. For this, if the body will be able to move, or we can say it will be able to cross the highest point H without any problem, if TH is positive. If TH will be negative, then body will come back without completing its whole circular path. So I am taking TH greater than 0 here. What is the value of TH? M by R U square minus 5GR greater than equal to 0. On solving this, I will get it as U will be greater than equal to under root of 5GR. So this is the minimum velocity at the lowest point. If the object is moving with this initial velocity at the point L, then it will be able to complete the vertical circle. And if the object is not moving with this initial velocity, then it will come back without completing the circular path. And if I also want to find the minimum velocity at highest point, minimum velocity at highest point, so similarly, what I can do, minimum velocity at highest point, we know the formula for the V, and formula for the V was V is equals to V square is equals to U square minus 2GH. What is the value of U? If I am taking it as 5GR, U square is equals to 5GR, then it will be 5GR minus 2G. What will be height at the highest point? It will be twice of radius, 2R. So velocity at the highest point, minimum velocity at the highest point will be equal to under root of gr. So this is the minimum velocity at the highest point, and this one is the minimum velocity at the lowest point. Now we will find some special cases in this circular motion. I am saying that there are two particular heights, h1 and h2. Two particular heights h1 and h2, and I will take that the body will oscillate about the lowest point at in some cases, or in some cases the object will go and crosses the middle point and then again comes back, or the actual case was the object is moving the complete circular motion. When the object is moving the complete circular motion, we have learned this whole And now we will find the special cases in which the u is that much less, so that it is not completing the complete circle, it is just oscillating about the point L, or u is slightly greater than this case, so that u object goes like this and comes back, so we can say it leaves the circular path. Fine. So I am assuming that at height h1 velocity becomes zero. Velocity becomes zero, and when velocity becomes zero, then what will that height? I can write it as v square is equals to u square minus 2gh. When velocity becomes zero, so this part will be equal to zero, u square minus 2gh, height is h1, then we can write it as h1 will be equal to u square upon 2g. Fine. Now again, I am also assuming it as at h2 height, tension becomes zero in the string. Tension becomes zero. We will derive two cases, that's why we are doing this. So what will be happen? Tension will become zero. So tension at the general point will be this, m by r u square plus gr minus 3gh. And when tension becomes zero, then what we can write, u square plus gr minus 3gh1. Sorry, it was r minus 3gh2. At height h2, it occurs like this. So what will be h2 from here? H2 will be u square plus gr upon 3g. So this one is the height h1, and this one is the height h2. Now we will take two cases. In the first case, when the body will oscillate only if its velocity becomes zero earlier than the tension. Means the object is going like this and its velocity becomes zero, but still there is tension. The object, the velocity becomes zero, so what will happen? The tension is still there, so object will go like this again, and again velocity will become zero, then object will go like this again. Tension is not zero in this case, so we can say when velocity becomes zero earlier than the tension, then object will oscillate. So if velocity becomes zero earlier than the tension, means h1 will be less than h2 in that case. Hence writing it as h1 will be less than h2. So putting the values, both values here, h1 was u square upon 2g, and it is less than u square plus gr upon 3g. On solving this, we will get it as u will be less than equal to under root 2gr. So if the initial velocity at point L is this much, then what will happen? The object will oscillate. So the object will oscillate about the lowest point L. Means if the initial velocity at this point u is less than under root 2gr, then the object will oscillate like this and it will not complete the vertical circular motion. And if the object leaves the circular path in between, then I can say in that case, this is case first, and for case second, in that case what will happen? h1 will be greater than h2 for that case. So putting the value of h1, it will be u square upon 2g will be greater than u square plus gr upon 3g. On solving this, we will get it as u is greater than under root 2gr. So if the object is moving with this velocity, then object will go like this and again like this, or I can say the object will go like this and comes back. Due to the tension becomes zero and the velocity is not zero, so the object will leave its vertical path, or I can say leave the circular motion. So this case will be the object will leave circular path. The object will leave circular path. So we can summarize the whole thing as when The initial velocity is greater than 0 but less than under root 2gr, first case. And for the second case, initial velocity is more than 2gr but less than under root 5gr. And third case, initial velocity is greater than under root 5gr. Then in this case, when the velocity is less than or equal to root 2gr, the object will oscillate. In this case, when the initial velocity is more than this but less than this, the object will leave the circular path. And for this, when the initial velocity is greater than or equal to under root 5gr, the object will complete the circular path and the vertical motion will be completed.